Welcome everyone to Cartist Festival 2020, as mentioned on the theme of sustainability. And here we start our opening session on sustainability matters. Now is the time to act. And world, as you know, world is changing around us and climate change is real. And this session will discuss some of with our renowned speakers from automobile industry, public sector and corporates to share thoughtful perspectives on need for sustainable solution and impacts of automobile industry. Welcome to all esteemed panelists, and I would just like to go over and introduce Mr. Rajesh Menon, Director General of SIAM. He's Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers at New Delhi since October 2019. And Mr. Rajesh was earlier the Deputy Director General at the Confederation of Indian Industry and was responsible for leading CII's international engagement and facilitating the Indian industry to expand its global footprint through a range of specialized services, including business events and specific market facilitation in emerging markets. Welcome, Mr. Menon, to the Cartist Festival 2020. We are awaiting our next panelist, Mr. Devashish Sen, our IS officer from the government of West Bengal. We'll introduce him once he joins. Due to some technical issues, he's unable to join now. Next on our panelist is Shakir Ali ji. Padmashri. Shakir Ali is an Indian painter known for his Mughal and Persian miniature paintings. He was honored by the Government of India in 2013 by bestowing on him the Padma Shri, the fourth highest civilian award for his contributions to the field of art. A very warm welcome to Padma Shri Shakir Ali ji to the festival. Moderator of our festival is Mr. Avik Chattopadhyay from Experial, who has invested 22 years in the automobile and oil and gas industries with renowned names including Maruti Suzuki, Caltex, Exxon Mobil, Apollo Tires, PSA, Peugeot, Citroen and Volkswagen, and headed a global brand consulting firm called Safran Brand Consultants in India and South Asia for a year. We hand over to Mr. Avik Chattopadhyay to take over the conversation. Thank you so much, and once again a very warm welcome to the festival.
Thank you very much, Bhavya. Thank you, Himanshu. Thank you to the entire Cartist team for giving us this time and the space on your festival to share our thoughts. You know, there are three leaders from different facets of industry and life who will be sharing their thoughts on a subject which is extremely apt for the world today and the world tomorrow, which is sustainability. The topic is sustainability matters. Now is the time to act. And the three gentlemen that I have the pleasure of interacting with today on the panel, they are domain experts in their own fields. I will actually start with Mr. Menon. Mr. Menon, sir, given the industry that you represent, the automobile industry, given its size, its stature, its clout, and you know, its sheer contribution to the Indian economy, you know, for you, sustainability, I'm sure, is much bigger than just to do with environmental protection. So, what would like to hear from you, your opening thoughts on the subject of sustainability matters. Now is the time to act.
Thank you, Abhi, and sincere thanks to the Cartist team for inviting me to be part of this interesting session and interesting deliberations. We as SIAM are committed to support Cartist, and we've had the privilege of having them at our Auto Expo editions in the past editions, and we look forward to continuing engagement going forward. Coming to the theme of sustainability, sustainability is from a transport perspective, if I can talk from transport sector, sustainable transport have all the three dimensions of sustainability: social, economic, and environmental sustainability. So we need to address all three in a very comprehensive manner to address the whole issue of sustainability, and which primarily means that the services and infrastructure for mobility of people and goods should be affordable, should be accessible, should be efficient, and should be resilient, and at the same point of time, minimizing the greenhouse gas and reducing the environmental impact. So it's a very comprehensive way of looking at sustainable transport. Obviously, it also should include fair and affordable access to trade, to jobs, to markets, education, healthcare, other services. So that is the way we look at sustainable transport. And if I can just bring in the United Nations Agenda of Sustainable Development, the 2030 Agenda, there is a sustainable transport a part of that overall SDG 2030 goal, where we have been linked to many such targets, linked to health, linked to energy, linked to resilient infrastructure, sustainable consumption, production, and also climate change. So we have a lot to do in the overall gamut and domain of sustainability.
Thank you, sir, for those opening remarks. You know, bringing in the perspective of the automobile industry into this subject. Cartist is a platform where automobiles and art actually come together. And we have amongst us Shakir Aliji, you know, renowned in the area of miniature art. Shakir Aliji, you know, when we talk about sustainability as a subject, you know, from your perspective, the perspective of an artist, the perspective of the artist community, the perspective of, you know, ये हम सुनते हैं कि यू नो ओल्ड स्टाइल्स ऑफ आर्ट ओल्ड आर्ट फॉर्म्स आर डाइंग आउट दे नीड सपोर्ट दे नीड टू बी सस्टेनेबल दे नीड टू बी नर्चर्ड दे नीड टू बी फंडेड दे नीड यू नो द कम्युनिटी कम्स टुगेदर सो आपके यू नो इनिशियल इंप्रेशंस ऑन दिस टॉपिक की सस्टेनेबिलिटी मैटर्स नाउ इज द टाइम टू एक्ट फ्रॉम योर पर्सपेक्टिव फ्रॉम योर फील्ड आप क्या बताएंगे
सबसे पहले तो मैं शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहता हूँ आर्टिस्ट का कि उन्होंने मुझे ये मंच पर आमंत्रित किया और इसके साथ साथ हिमांशु जी का कि हिमांशु जी इस चीज में को लेकर काफी सीरियस हैं और अक्सर वो हर साल ही इस तरह का प्रोग्राम करते रहते हैं और उनका ये मेरा सौभाग्य कि मैं उनके प्रोग्रामों में कई बार मैंने उसमें शामिल हुआ हूँ और अच्छे से नजदीक से देखा है जैसा कि उन्होंने कार्टिस्ट नाम रखा है कार प्लस आर्टिस्ट कार्ट प्लस आर्ट तो कार्टिस्ट उन्होंने जो रखा है तो वो आर्ट और कला जो उनका जो ऑटोमोबाइल का है उसको दोनों को जोड़ दिया तो ये एक बड़ी उनकी एक अच्छी सोच है और जहां तक आर्टिस्टों का भी जो COVID-19 के बाद जो लोगों का हाल हुआ है कला का या किसी भी क्षेत्र में चाहे वो बिजनेस सेक्टर हो चाहे वो आर्ट फील्ड हो उसमें लोगों को अभी बहुत ज्यादा जरूरत है एक अच्छे प्लेटफॉर्म की एक अच्छे जरिए की जिसके जरिए वो अपनी कला को अपनी जो भी वो हमारी जो भारतीय कलाएं हैं या जो चाहे वो लघु चित्रकारी हो या राजस्थान की पटचित्र हो या जो भी कलाएं हैं हमारी लोक कलाएं हैं उनका जो एक्सपोजर होना चाहिए था वो नहीं हो पा रहा है क्योंकि वो क्योंकि COVID-19 में सब चीज बंद है ना तो आर्ट गैलरीज खुली हुई है ऐसी कंडीशन में जो कुछ कलाएं ऐसी हैं जो हमारी जो बिल्कुल डाइंग आर्ट होने जा रही हैं जो पहले से ही काफी उनकी स्थिति अच्छी नहीं थी लेकिन अभी और ज्यादा इस जो COVID-19 की वजह से काफी उसमें और गिरावट आई है कलाकार जो है ना वो अपना काम ढंग से नहीं कर पा रहे उसको सेल नहीं कर पा रहेंगे तो नेचुरली और छोड़ छोड़ के चले जाएंगे और वो बहुत सी कलाएं जो है ना वो पहले ही हालत खस्ता थी उनकी और उसकी और ज्यादा हो जाएगी तो मैं तो यही कहना चाहूंगा कि जो हमारे कलाकार हैं उनको आर्थिक सहायता की भी जरूरत है गवर्नमेंट इसके बारे में कुछ सोचे लेकिन हमारे हमारा दुर्भाग्य है कि हमारी जो गवर्नमेंट है वो दूसरी और अलग अलग उसमें उलझी पड़ी है और इस ओर कला और संस्कृति की तरफ ध्यान नहीं दिया जा रहा तो मैं इस प्लेटफॉर्म इसके माध्यम से कहना चाहूंगा कि बहुत से ऐसे कलाकार हैं जो बहुत ही नामी कलाकार हैं और वो जैसे ओम जायसवाल हैं हमारे राजबेर में अच्छी अच्छी पदों पर रहे अच्छी अच्छी जगहों पर रहे प्रोफेसर रहे पढ़ाया भी बच्चों को लेकिन अभी उनका फोन मुझे मिला था तो पता चला कि वो काफी दयनीय स्थिति में गुजर रहे हैं ऐसी कंडीशन में कलाकारों को अभी हेल्प की भी जरूरत है और सपोर्ट की भी जरूरत है इसके साथ साथ उन कला को और कलाकारों को जो है ना कहीं ना कहीं मंच चाहिए या कोई भी ऐसा प्रोग्राम ही होना चाहिए जिसके माध्यम से वो अपनी कला का कहीं भी प्रदर्शन कर सकते हैं कहीं बेच सकते हैं उसको बेचने का एक तरीका भी हो तो ज्यादा बेटर है
थैंक यू काफी काफी इम्पोर्टेंट मुद्दे आपने मतलब उठाए हैं यहाँ पर और इसी पे आई विल गो बैक टू मिस्टर मेनन नाउ सर यू नो एज यू मेंशन्ड अबाउट द यूएन सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स यू नो एज वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट देयर आर 17 गोल्स but they are all interlinked, you know, which is very important, which means, you know, one goal cannot live in isolation or one goal cannot be achieved without actually working on the other 16, which you also mentioned about the different kinds of goals. Now, Shakirji has raised a very important issue that, you know, art forms, artists, communities of artisans, they anyway need constant support. And especially in times like this, you know, when they don't get any forum to express what they're really doing, they would need more support. Now, one can obviously say that, yes, I mean, you would look forward to the government for support, but the government will then turn back and say, how much can we do? Because do we actually work on the calamity on ground or do we work on such issues? So here, you know, given your background, you know, in CII and now currently your role in SIAM, you know, what kind of role, and I know this is slightly going outside of, you know, the typical scope of the automobile industry, but what kind of an active role can the automakers and the industry play in trying to help and support the preservation of art forms in the country?
You know, Avik, what's happening is industry has clearly a role to play to engage with communities. And there are various ways and means of engaging with communities. As SIAM, of course, we have some specific outreach initiatives with that objective of engagement in mind. But there is so much more we can do. And I think clearly there is much more we can be done vis-a-vis engaging with the artist community. And there are roles which sectoral associations can play, like SIAM, which is a little bit more limited since we are specific to one sector. But there are the role with other associations which are largely overarching in nature should play. But there's clearly a lot we can do as industry to engage with artist community, which is probably not happening to the extent it should be happening.
Thank you, Mr. Menon. Welcome, Mr. Sen. Welcome.
Terrific problem joining in. I think this was slightly different. We do Zoom meetings all the time, but this was slightly different. But anyway, so now we are. Please continue. Sorry, somebody was speaking.
No, Mr. Menon from SIAM has just spoken. So, you know, because you just joined, the first question I had asked both Mr. Menon and Mr. Shakir Ali was, you know, your initial thoughts on the subject that sustainability matters. Now is the time to act, you know, especially given your really interesting role of actually building a complete township. You know, I see your LinkedIn posts. You are always doing something new every day. You know, whether it is, you know, cycling, whether it is, you know, a new cafeteria, or whether it is, you know, starting, you know, electric chargers in some part of the city. So from your perspective, I would just like to hear your first thoughts on the subject of sustainability matters.
I mean, it's such a self-evident question that sustainability matters that it needs in these days no explanation. But however, if I were to say very quickly, then I would say that since I am involved in building up a new town and making it look into the future, we are making structural changes so that sustainability is kind of woven in. It is in the fabric. So what do I mean by that? For example, we are having densified cities. What does densified cities mean? Normally in India, the FAR or FSI, whatever you prefer to call, hovers in the region of 2 to 2.25. In a new town in central business district, we have gone up to 6. So that means we have tall buildings on the same plot of land, and we'll have a large number of people staying together. So what we are aiming at is basically what we see in New York and Singapore, where you travel with lifts rather than in cars. So you have to go from your residence to your place of work, but this doesn't have to be separated. It can be all towered in. And those concept of vertical cities, and since elevators and lifts and other things are electrically operated, we don't want certainly it should be coal fired. It should be either nuclear or renewable energy, solar, wind, etc. Then we are going towards sustainability by making walkable cities, vertical cities, that's one. And while that will take time, we are spending time on building cycling tracks. One of the main reasons why mothers don't want to let their child go on a cycle to a nearby shop or a cinema house or somebody is because of the safety factor. So we are having grid separated cycle tracks with all signals and precautions in a very scientific manner. Already we have built in New Town, Kolkata, more than 19 kilometers of grid separated cycle tracks, and we want to take it forward. In an Indian city, there is people don't always buy cycles. I mean, in a rural settings, it's slightly different. So in Eastern India, though it started in some parts of other parts of India, in Eastern India, we are the first place to have apps-based public cycle sharing scheme. It's already running. It's called Chartered Bike, and along with Surat, Jharkhand, and a few other places, they are also running this, and it's hugely popular. In the 1 month of its operation, huge number of people have taken it. So what we are trying to say is that starting from building the city, starting from structurally keeping 30% green and motorable streets, and now we are involving the people. We are involving the people, and we are right now into a scheme called Streets for the People, not for the car. I think the cartist lobby will not be very happy with me, but we are saying that why do you need a car? Let's make streets for pedestrians. In fact, we have identified two streets where cars run now. We have had alternative routes. Let the car drive a little more, no problem. But from A to B, the straight line would be reserved for pedestrians, children, wheelchairs, and cycles. A to B via C would be for cars. So whenever we are finding alternative routes with two prominent origin destination, we are trying to urge people that streets are meant for people and not for cars. And while two is just a starting point, so we are trying to do, and we are building up happy streets. So street is a place where you love to be there with your children, with your family, with your friends, for your discussions and other things. So not to deviate too much from the main topic of sustainability, the more we avoid transportation, origin, destination travels, the more we encourage people to ride into cycles and walking, the more we make safe streets, the more we make residences and office, that is work and home together, as close as possible, we will have gone in for sustainable cities. It's of course, if you have to have cars, that is, I think many people may have already mentioned, it's very cliche that we need to go towards electric vehicles. And since electric vehicles don't run because of what they call charge anxiety or range anxiety, we are first putting electric chargers, whether anybody buys it or not. So right now in Newtown, we have around 40, 50 chargers. I cannot say that too many offtake is there, but we want to give the mental peace that next time the Tatas come up with an electric vehicle, you know that the charging stations are all located very well and you can rest assured. The last point that I would like to mention at DoubtGo is that we have partnered with a private company, not partnered, basically we have gone into an agreement through a procurement process. Lithium in Bangalore is a company that is doing good work in corporate carpooling. And for them, we have put in a bank of 25 electric chargers. You see, the problem in cities is that you don't get the place to put the charger. And more important, a charger doesn't take much time. It's the size of a refrigerator. But when the car stands in front of it, it eats up a lot of space, and parking space is very, very scarce in a busy city. So what we are doing is that we have identified areas where we can provide a parking space for the electric vehicles to be charged and places. And we have a kind of revenue sharing. So the latest that has come up through a procurement process is 87 paisa. What is 87 paisa? 87 paisa per kilowatt hour, that is one unit of electricity sold to a electric car or consumed by an electric car, comes back to the government, to the department. Why? Because the space for setting up the car parking and the charging is done. So this is on the road. I mean, it's going to come up in the next few months' time. This COVID brought us slightly slower. So 25 chargers are there, all being built, not by the government, by the lithium company. And what is lithium company doing? It is paying us whenever it is charging electricity. Electricity cost is theirs, only a margin of 87 paisa to us. That is discovered. That is a market discovered rate. And what are they doing? They are approaching corporate houses and say that what is it that you spend for your pool car? If you spend X rupees per month, I'll give you at X minus rupees per month because I'll spread out. In electric vehicle, the initial cost is more, but since you don't have fuel cost or not much of it, so therefore you can even out. It's just a question of simple arithmetic of arriving at an EMI that is based on kilometers run. And they are already contacting many people and they are very confident that this will be a success. If so, in the field of transportation, in the field of electric vehicles, where people are not very eager to buy because it costs much more, a Maruti Suzuki costs 7.5 lakhs, an electric vehicle will start from 11 lakhs. So who would like to spend 3 lakhs more? So therefore, this methodology of somebody coming in between and evening out, basically in the long run, after 3-4 years, it is going to match out. So that with a bank finance, they're trying to do. So in short, sustainability is important, of course, otherwise everything will stop. And we are trying to target it by making lifestyle changes, by making city level structural changes, by having policies that reward rainwater harvesting and solar rooftop energy production, by creating streets or converting streets into places where people will be encouraged to walk and cycle. And that way, we are trying to build a green city. And I cannot help in making the remark that New Town Kolkata has just received a platinum award in terms of green city certification by IGBC, that is Indian Green Building Council. So over to you.
Thank you, sir. Excellent perspective, you know, bringing in all aspects of sustainable life and livelihood. So thank you very much for sharing, you know, your thoughts on the subject and also as to how you're implementing your thoughts on ground in New Town Kolkata. Shakir ji, you know, you've obviously heard Mr. Menon, you've heard Mr. Sen as to what all they're doing. Mr. Sen in this very interesting city called New Town, Mr. Menon in the automobile industry. Now, aapka jo background hai art se, abhi, now going forward to sustain different art forms. Now, do you think that the artist or the artist community somewhere has to, आज तक क्या होता है कि आर्टिस्ट अपने स्टूडियो में काम करता है, अपने क्रिएशंस तैयार करता है, वो जैसे अपने स्कल्पचर्स हो गए, पेंटिंग्स हो गए, एक फिक्स्ड फॉर्म है, एक फिक्स्ड फॉर्मेट है और वो सदियों से चलता हुआ आ रहा है, मतलब फॉर सेंचुरीज इट इज ऑलवेज बीन द सेम. आई मीन यू नो समटाइम्स डू वी सी आर्ट फॉर्म्स गेटिंग इनटू यू नो into everyday life for that perspective. Aap kya sochte hain ki, you know, for sustainability of art and art forms, does the artist community also have to think new ideas, new ways in which they can collaborate, you know, with industry, in which they can collaborate with cities, in which they can collaborate with communities to ensure that tomorrow, khuda na khasta, aise ek aur koi pandemic aa jaye, aise ek aur koi emergency aa jaye, आपकी जो लाइवलीहुड है उसको हैम्पर ना करें, उसको हिट ना करें, क्योंकि आपका जो मेथड और एक्सप्रेशन जो है, आपको जो मीडियम और एक्सप्रेशन है वो बदल जाएगा, वो डिफरेंट होगा एंड दैट विल आल्सो इंश्योर सस्टेनेबिलिटी टू द कम्युनिटी. आप क्या सोचते हैं?
बहुत अच्छा आपने सवाल किया है, मैं इसके बारे में कहना चाहूंगा कि जो हमारी आर्ट फॉर्म है नेचुरली वो एक दायरे से बाहर आनी चाहिए, और उसके लिए जैसे अभी मेरे मुझे कुछ ऑर्डर मिला था, मैंने उसके ऊपर काम भी किया है थोड़ा सा। जैसे मुझे टाइटन वॉच कंपनी वालों ने एक ऑर्डर किया था कि मैं गोल्ड की वॉचेस बनाना चाहते हैं हम लोग, और उसमें हम डायल के ऊपर आपकी जो मिनीचर पेंटिंग है उसको डालना चाहते हैं, और आपके नाम से ही वो सारा मेंशन करेंगे, और उसके ऊपर उन्होंने काम किया। मैंने उसके साथ वर्कशॉप किया उनके साथ बैठ के, और बताया कि भाई इसमें इस तरह की पेंटिंग बनाई जा सकती है, किस तरह बनाई जा सकती है, जैसे वो जो मीनाकारी होती है उसके हिसाब से जो कलर होते हैं उनको लेकर हमने एक नया पर्सपेक्टिव तैयार किया, तो उनको पसंद आया। अभी अंडर प्रोसेस है, वो भी मार्केट में आया नहीं, लेकिन उसके ऊपर काम हुआ। इसी तरह से कार्टिस्ट भी एक कार्ट और आर्ट दोनों मिलाकर हम लोग, जैसे हिमांशु जी ने एक दो वर्कशॉप किए थे जिसमें ऑटो ऑटो के ऊपर काम करवाया था, कारों के ऊपर, पुरानी गाड़ियों पर काम करवाया था, तो हम हमारी जो कला है या हमारे जो आर्टिजन है वो लोग अगर इस तरह का सोचते हैं और वो इस तरह के व्हीकल के ऊपर भी कुछ अपनी कला का को बनाते हैं, और उसको जब चूंकि वो मार्केट में जाएगी, बाजार में जाएगी, उससे बढ़िया कोई जरिया नहीं हो सकता, वो लोग जो लोग देखेंगे तो एक अपने आप एक नया स्टाइल होगा, जिससे हमारे जो कलाकार हैं, जो हमारे यूथ है या जो भी हमारे कलाकार हैं जो अलग अलग फॉर्म में काम करते हैं, उनको उस पर काम करने का मजा आएगा, और मजा आएगा तो उसकी एक मार्केट भी मिल सकता है, उसको एक नया एक आयाम मिल सकता है। और चूंकि जिस तरह के व्हीकल्स आपने बताया कि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक व्हीकल्स ज्यादा आ रहे हैं, तो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक के हिसाब से भी मतलब हो या कोई भी हो, उन व्हीकल्स के ऊपर काम किया जा सकता है, और वो व्हीकल मार्केट में मुझे लगता है कि काफी अप्रिशिएट किए जाएंगे अगर वो अपने तरीके से, अपने आइडियाज के ऊपर, अपने डिजाइन के ऊपर अगर नई तरीके से बनाए जाते हैं या उन पर काम होता है, तो वो मेरे ख्याल से ज्यादा बेनिफिटेबल भी हो सकता है। इसके बारे में आप लोग सोच सकते हैं या डिस्कस कर सकते हैं। मेरा चूंकि मिनीचर से लगाव रहा है, तो मेरा काफी जो काम है मिनीचर के हिसाब से है चल रहा है, लेकिन मेरी जो कला जगत के मेरे जो युवा कलाकार हैं उनकी जो स्थिति देखने के बाद मुझे लगता है कि इस बारे में सोचना बहुत जरूरी है, और आपने ये पैनल जो लगा अभी जो स्थापित किया, ये मंच दिया, उसके हिसाब से भी मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि जितने भी कलाकार हैं वो हमारी जो हमारी भारतीय कलाएं हैं, जो लघु चित्रकारी है या हमारी जो भी ट्रेडिशनल आर्ट फॉर्म है, वो कहीं ना कहीं उनका यूटिलाइज होना चाहिए, वो कहीं ना कहीं लोगों का उसका इस्तेमाल होना चाहिए, जिससे कलाकारों को कला भी जिंदा रहे और हमारी अपनी भारतीय संस्कृति है या हमारी कल्चर है वो भी एक जगह एस्टेब्लिश रहे और लोगों को उसको फायदा भी मिले और लोगों को मजा आए देखने के अंदर। तो ये मेरा ख्याल है।
सही बोला आपने, क्योंकि इसमें मैं ये समझता हूँ, मतलब मेरी ये बिलीफ है कि बहुत ज्यादा और भी बहुत ज्यादा कोलैबोरेशन होना चाहिए सोसाइटी, बिजनेस, इंडस्ट्री, आर्ट के अलग अलग सेक्शंस के एक साथ काम करने के लिए, क्योंकि तभी जब आप लोग सॉल्यूशंस निकालेंगे जो को क्रिएटिव हैं, विच आर को क्रिएटेड सॉल्यूशंस, वही सॉल्यूशंस एक्चुअली सस्टेनेबल बनेंगे इन द लॉन्ग रन। ऑन दैट नोट मिस्टर मेनन, यू नो देयर इज अ सर्टेन सेक्शन ऑफ let's say society or a certain section of media or activists who always feel that industry and sustainability are not really let's say merging subsets or are not conjoined. Okay, they don't always end up working together. Somewhere maybe the goals of sustainability, the goals to preserve things, the goals to nurture things, the goals to protect certain aspects of life and livelihood and the environment seem to be in conflict with industry. What is your take on this? Because, given the automobile industry's key role, especially in aspects of, environment, emissions, and also improving, the average livelihood of people who are associated with it, you play a very crucial role.
Thank you, Avik, for asking this important question. You see, let me answer it in two parts. First is, of course, what industry is doing to bridge that gap. As you said, people perceive it that industry and sustainability do not go to hand in hand. What we have been doing to in terms of sustainability, I just want to talk about that. And second part is, how do we engage with communities? And that's something which we have started doing since last 1 or 2 years, but we would like to deepen that engagement going forward and probably increase the scale. Coming to the first part on what industry has been doing, you know, there has been several elements the last few years where industry has progressed on the angle of, if I can just talk about for now, on environment. And first, of course, is industry made a very major transition to BS6. It's a major technology upgradation which has happened in very shortest time, just 3 years transition we made to BS6. So coming 1st April 2020 this year, we're all into BS6 vehicles. So, and BS6 vehicles are extremely clean. They are, in fact, if I have numbers in terms of NOx, in terms of sulfur, in terms of PM, they are much cleaner vehicles. So we have a higher technology in terms of vehicles coming in across segments, it's not just cars, but two-wheelers, commercial vehicles, trucks, buses, they're all BS6. That's a major change. Second, industry is, you know, working a lot on new technologies. And Mr. Sen spoke about electric vehicles. There are already products coming in. Last year, we saw many products coming in electric vehicles. You will see, as Mr. Sen mentioned, there are three anxieties and we are seeing those being addressed. So there is a price anxiety, there's a range anxiety, and then there is, of course, overall technology or charging anxiety. So charging infrastructure anxiety, range anxiety, and price anxiety. So these are being addressed. These are very much being discussed with in various forms of the governments. And you will see last year itself, we saw many large players bringing in electric vehicle products, and you will see that transition and that penetration increasing going forward. But besides electric vehicles, there's a lot of work happening on alternate fuels. In fact, as per data with me, around 100 models of CNG vehicles are already in the market. There's a lot of work happening on alternate fuels. There is vehicles are now very much compatible to run on different blends of ethanol and biofuels. There is ethanol 10% blending, which is all vehicles are now compatible for that blend. We are discussing in terms of high increasing the blend going forward, what could be the roadmap. So there's a lot of work happening on alternate fuels, and which includes electric vehicles. And third element, which I want to mention is, you know, there is a lot of work happening on recyclability, which is not spoken about enough, but a lot of work happening on recyclability through better designing and using advanced material in manufacturing for new vehicles and making new vehicles much more recyclable. So from a transition to BS6, from using different types of alternate fuels, including electric vehicles, and from angle of recyclability and on products, making the products more recyclable, these are three elements which I wanted to point out as what industry is moving towards from an environment perspective. From a second part of community engagement, we have been engaged in a village in a district in Punjab, in Patiala, in a place called Jaso Majra. It's a project we have been pushing and partnering with CII as SIAM, and which automobile industry is very closely engaged with. Our purpose in that is, it's in 9 villages in Patiala district in place called Jaso Majra, 7,400 acres of farmland. And we have been working with the community there to ensure that there is no stubble burning. And in fact, in that, in 2018, we had 71% success in terms of reduction. In 2019, we had 85%. And the current project which is going on, we are aiming at 95% reduction in stubble burning in those 9 villages in Jaso Majra. We're providing them mulchers. We're providing them different type of technology to ensure that they don't need to burn stubble. We've also got a pilot project which is on microbial digester called ReLife, which we are implementing in a project in Punjab on 38 acres, which this particular digester decomposes the crop residue in just around 3 to 4 weeks. So there are different types of ways in which we are engaging community. We just started doing that a few years back. You will see industry playing a much more proactive role in reaching out and doing larger outreach efforts going forward.
Very interesting examples. Thank you for sharing these examples, you know, because the typical impression is, you know, large industries, you know, large, powerful industries, especially in the areas of mobility and energy, you know, they are quite, insular, and they don't always go out and try out, you know, projects like you spoke about, you know, of how to minimize this incidence of the crop stubble burning that basically just helps communities all across, I mean, right from Punjab down to Delhi, NCR, and even further every year. Devashi, sir, I would now basically link, you know, a town with mobility and want to hear your perspective on the fine balance that one has to work out between public and private transport, you know, just to make life more sustainable for everyone. And as you so nicely said, that, you know, you should basically be ideally be walking to work, you know, as much as possible, or maybe even cycling to work at the most, or using, according to me, say, you know, an electric three-wheeler, auto rickshaw, to ferry you from your home to your place of work and back. But then that is somewhere, you know, a bit counterproductive to what, you know, any business enterprise wants to do, which is also to make personal vehicles and actually to generate revenues, make profits and plow it back into business. Because, you know, the automobile industry, I've read up, you know, it directly engages close to 500,000 people and indirectly engages close to 35, 40 million people. So if personal transport were to die down, a large number of people would suddenly be out of livelihoods. So where do you know, your perspectives of sustainability through this fine balance between public and private transport, given your experience with Newtown?
I would first say two remarks about what Mr. Shakir Ali and what Mr. Menon said. To Mr. Shakir Ali, I have this query in me. Himanshu had come to Newtown Eco Park, and at least 2 years he had made beautiful designs on old cars, but probably it's not allowed. I mean, under the laws, I mean, you can't paint your car any which way and go. I think there is some legal issue. So I would like to know that if there is a chance of having such kind of art on, if it is not legal in cars, but in street furniture, let us say, the bus stands, the footpaths, the benches, the lampshades, is there a way to, you know, make our cities, our roads, our people more colorful, more attractive? This is one part of the question. Art in cityscape other than car also, since I understand car, there may be a bit of a problem. To Mr. Menon, I have this question by saying that, number one, it is very good to know about your recyclingness of cars. So many of us, middle income group, upper middle income, and certainly higher income group, it's a new model, so we must have it. So what happens to the old model? I don't know. I come from a salaried class, middle income, but already the two cars that had been there, you know, some, as you go up your social ladder, as you go up your life. So what do you do with your old Zen when the new Estilo has come in? It just accumulates. So it will be very good if we can really, everybody has this urge, like our mobile phones. A new model comes, so we'll throw cut the G and let's have a new one. So if the car manufacturers themselves take it back, like Apple is doing, I know, for iPhones, they take back in their factory itself, use it for new products. So that's the maximum utilization instead of breaking it down to the elements of extracting the gold and throwing everything away. So it would be very good indeed if the whole car industry came up like this and put in your old model, you use it, the owner also gets something. It's a very useful thought, I think, in this discussion of sustainability. The other thing about what Abhik asked about, how do you place it? I mean, mass transit or personal transport versus walking, cycling, and three-wheeler riding. First of all, I think in this terrifically bad COVID pandemic situation, the car industry is pretty happy. It was very low during these days, but now it's picking up more than last year. And one reason is, of course, is that people don't want to get into public Uber, Ola, and buses, trains, if they can afford. Of course, there are people who can't afford that. But even second-hand vehicles and cars are good because I know it's safe, it's sanitized, and so on and so forth. But that's a temporary phenomenon, if you see. In the long run, I certainly think that the lower segment will be coming up more. To give a live example, we are going for the cycle sharing scheme. And for every cycle that you pedal with your wheels using muscle power, we are getting from next month three e-cycles. That is, there's a small battery, small motor. The idea is if it runs out, you pedal the rest of the way. But for the first half, let us say 10 kilometers or something, you don't have to spend any energy, no sweating, no wet clothes, etc. And if you look at China, if you look at Europe, if you look at many places around the world, Amsterdam being the, of course, the great place, people are just trying to move away from cars. And basically from a sustainability point of view, but this won't happen very quickly in India. So therefore in India, my point of view is, of course, you have monorails and other things, it's good, but if not buses, if not shared taxis, if not shared by motorbikes, the more we share, the more resources we save. I think car manufacturers must listen to this. What are people doing? Ola Uber drivers, they're putting a plastic sheet so that the virus does not cross from the driver to the passenger sitting behind. So everybody needs a privacy. Everybody needs to be protected from infection. But we need to optimize the seats available. I mean, there's no fun on three seats remaining vacant, only one seat. That is not sustainability. So my last final thought to Mr. Menon and his team is that, would you design cars that are sharing friendly, if there is a word like them, share friendly? If there are two doors, only two people can come in, but there are six seats inside. I mean, how do you think people will jump over each other and do that? It's not a friendly design. So each seat, one separate kind of a thing. That's from a sustainability point of view only, I'm saying. So that's it. One question to Mr. Padmasri to summarize that, आप कैसे आर्ट को स्ट्रीट में लाएंगे? कार में अगर कार तो है, Himanshu is doing a great job. But other than that, on the footpath, on the bus stand, on the post box, on the lamp post, is there a way? आपको क्या सोचना है? And Mr. Menon, would you go for personal sharing of cars? Any design concept?
Very interesting perspectives and two very interesting questions also, sir.
So Mr. Sen actually pointed out two questions, two queries. Let me try and answer both of them. First one is on recycled vehicles. See, there are now recyclable guidelines of Ministry of Environment, which is now very well in place. We have been engaged with Government of India on what is called a scrappage policy. The whole intention of the scrappage policy was to have a set of scrappage yards. So currently recycling is happening in a very unorganized way in an unorganized sector. So we should set up scrappage yards. We already have some of the OEMs who have set up their own scrappage yards, but we'll see much more people coming forward and setting up these yards once there is a proper framework in place. So there's a discussion going on from a scrappage yard perspective so that we have many more such centers across. And then there's also discussion on a scrappage scheme in which you scrap an old vehicle, you get a scrappage certificate and you take a scrappage certificate and then buy a new vehicle. And there is some sort of a fiscal incentive given so that you're encouraged to replace your old vehicle. And that is very, very important because today we have a situation where we have much more cleaner BS6 vehicles running on the road, and then you have a BS2 and BS3 also on the road. So you need to ensure that you get as many new vehicles which are environmentally much more friendly on the road. And this is one policy we are discussing with the government where all OEMs are engaged with. So we are hopeful that this will be announced very soon. We have been assured that this will be announced very soon. So we're looking forward to that. And that probably answers a large part of Mr. Sen's question. A second point, yes, design. There are various innovative designs being discussed. And as you rightly pointed out, something which will make sharing much more comfortable and much more easy within a vehicle framework. We have a styling and design committee. There is already discussion going on this, but I will take this feedback through and see what can be explored to make this commercially feasible in every aspect.
So Mr. Sen, over the next, say, 12 months, okay, in your role, in a very interesting role of, you know, building this city and this community and or the communities that live within this city, in the next 12 months, what are really your key challenges or the key goals that you've set for yourself in the area of sustainability?
We have a lot of things, so that will be off the topic. For instance, one I cannot resist mentioning, though it may not be very relevant. In all the communities in this new town, what we are doing is that for each community, we are putting a ranking system. Who is best using solar energy? Who is best taking care of waste plastics? Who is taking care of segregation of solid waste at source, and so on and so forth? Very, very laudable, something like the Millennium Development Goals of the UN. And we will give them ranking so that they fight with each other and they go towards a better position tomorrow. But in the field of transportation, I would say that intermediate LRT and electric vehicles are the immediate future concerns. The more we have metro railway big, like the Delhi Metro or the Hyderabad Metro, it's so difficult and costly. It's very difficult to solve the problems. So what we need for sustainable, shareable transport is that shorter. Though I am not a key advocate of tramways, many in Kolkata would give their lives for tramways, but I have a different point of view. If it is elevated, a tram going on elevated, which does not eat away or steal road space from our cars, is a splendid solution. So that is one thing that we are looking. We are getting into feasibility studies, and we are also getting into pod-like transfers. What is pod-like transfer? If you have been to Heathrow in London, from one terminal to other terminal, there are small kind of a two-train system without a driver. So it just moves in the sky and among the three terminals. Like that solution also, we are saying electricity driven. It can run like a taxi. 3-4 people also would make it viable. It has to be autonomous. And we are also looking at these kind of solutions because metro is very costly and tramways are out of the way. So LRT in short, a light rail transport and electric vehicles and electric cycles. I think these are very important from the transportation sustainability.
Very interesting. So I guess after say a period of 12-15 months, we should be seeing some interesting developments in new town.
I visit
Kolkata twice a year, though this year I've gone there only once, but I'm sure to see and appreciate the progress there. Shakir sahab, now you're back and you're connected.
We can hear.
आवाज आ रही है सर. तो सेन सर ने आपको जो सवाल पूछा था कि आपकी कंट्रीब्यूशन पूरे एक शहर के पूरे जो आर्ट और स्ट्रीट फर्नीचर और लाइटिंग और जो बिल्डिंग्स में है उसमें उभर सकता है कि नहीं, इससे आपके विचार.
इस तरह का सेन साहब को बहुत अच्छा सवाल है और बहुत अच्छी बात उन्होंने कही भी है. तो मैं इसके बारे में कहना चाहूंगा कि हमारे राजस्थान में जो भी रेलवे स्टेशन हैं, वहां उसका आर्ट फॉर्म को बनाया जा रहा है. जैसे भीलवाड़ा है, भीलवाड़ा अगर आप रेलवे स्टेशन पर जाएंगे तो वहां के जो कलाकार हैं, जो लोकल कलाकार हैं, उनको चांस दिया गया कि फर पेंटिंग से उसको बनाया जाए. हमारे जयपुर में भी, जयपुर के जो स्टेशन हैं उन पर भी काम किया जा रहा है. या हम साउथ में जाते हैं, वहां पर भी उसका इस्तेमाल किया जा रहा है. फर्नीचर में भी ये बहुत अच्छा आइडिया है. फर्नीचर में भी ऑलरेडी जोधपुर वगैरह में काफी फर्नीचर के ऊपर काम होता है, मिनिएचर पेंटिंग बनाई जाती है और इस तरह का ये बहुत प्रचलन तो चल ही रहा है. लेकिन यहाँ हम बात कर रहे हैं कार्टिस्ट की, कार के ऊपर. तो इस तरह के कार के ऊपर भी माध्यम स्टार्ट हो सकता है. जैसे आपने बताया था सैन साहब ने कि एक जो टैक्सीज होती हैं, टैक्सी चलती हैं, उनके बीच में कर्टेन लगाकर हम लोग वहां पर भी उसका यूज कर सकते हैं अपनी कला का, अपनी आर्ट का, ताकि लोग देखें, उसके बारे में समझें और थोड़ा सा उसका एक कैप्शन डाल के बताएं कि ये फला फॉर्म है, ये फला आर्ट है. तो वो चीज भी एक अच्छा आइडिया है. और लैंप पोल हैं, जो बेंचेस हैं, जो हमारे जो भी पब्लिक जो प्लेसेस हैं वहां पर कुछ इस तरह की चीजें लगाई जा सकती हैं, जिससे हमारा आर्ट फॉर्म ज्यादा बढ़ सकता है और आगे निकल सकता है. इसी तरह से व्हीकल्स के ऊपर भी, मतलब अगर कुछ इस तरह की कुछ चीजें अगर डाली जाती हैं, और जिस तरह के हिमांशु जी ने एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया था, ऑटो वगैरह पे भी काम किया करवाया था लोगों से, पुरानी ओल्ड कार्स के ऊपर भी काम करवाया था, तो वो बहुत लोगों ने सराहा, बहुत अच्छा लगा लोगों को. और क्योंकि मैं कहना चाहूंगा कि जयपुर जो है ना वो एक टूरिस्ट प्लेस है. यहाँ पर लोग जो बाहर से हर कंट्रीज के लोग आते हैं तो वो देखते हैं उससे काफी आगे मिलेगा, लेकिन कोविड का चक्कर है, कोविड की वजह से लोग अभी घर से नहीं निकल रहे हैं, पता नहीं कब तक रहेगा। उस दौरान जो कलाकार है, जो कला है हमारी, वो मर ना जाए, डाइड ना हो जाए, इसके लिए हमें और हमारी जो भारत सरकार है, गवर्नमेंट या स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है, उसको सोचना चाहिए, उसके बारे में कुछ करना चाहिए। वो नहीं हो पा रहा है, इसके लिए बड़ी एक तकलीफ है, एक ज़हनी परेशानी है कि कहीं ऐसा ना हो हमारे कलाकार छोड़ छोड़ कर किसी दूसरी चीजों में लग जाए, या अपनी और किसी मेहनत मजदूरी या कोई शॉप है या दुकानें हैं या कोई छोटे मोटे काम खोल के करके बैठ जाएंगे, तो जो हुनर है उनका, जो बड़ी मुश्किल से उनके अंदर हम लोगों ने, हमारे मेरे शागिर्दी में भी बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट सीखे हैं, तो वो भी छोड़ छोड़ के जा रहे हैं। कोई उसने अभी, कुछ लोगों ने अपनी परचूनी की जो ग्रोसरी की शॉप खोल ली है, किसी ने कुछ अपने जरिए, क्योंकि उनको रोजी रोटी चलानी है, तो कुछ अपने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक दुकानें खोल के बैठे हैं। तो वो सब चीजें, ये थोड़ा सा एक सोचने का विषय है कि हम लोग इस बारे में सोचें और क्या कर सकते हैं। ये एक अच्छा वो है माध्यम। तो अभी आप लोगों ने, जैसे आपने बहुत सारी आइडियाज दिए, मैं ड्रेसडन गया था जर्मनी, वहां भी मैंने देखा कि लोग जो है ना व्हीकल जो है सैटरडे संडे भी यूज करते हैं, अपना खुद का ओन व्हीकल जो होता है, और वहां मोस्टली जितना ट्रांसपोर्टेशन है वो गवर्नमेंट का ट्रांसपोर्टेशन यूज करते हैं, प्लस वो साइकिल 2-3-4-5 किलोमीटर तो साइकिलिंग ही करते हैं, और जगह जगह उनकी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक साइकिल्स होती हैं, वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चार्जर लगे हुए हैं, वहां लोग खड़ा कर देते हैं, स्टैंड कर देते हैं, उसके बाद चले जाते हैं, अपना काम करते हैं, वापस साइकिल निकालते हैं। तो ये ऐसा, यहाँ भी ऐसे ट्रैक्स बनने चाहिए हिंदुस्तान में भी, भारत में भी, और उस तरह का होना चाहिए कि कुछ आदमी की जो ज्यादातर बीमारियां हो रही हैं, आप हार्ट पेशेंट हो रहे हैं, या हम लोग फिजिकली मतलब हम लोग ज्यादा निकल नहीं पाते, या अपने एक्सरसाइज नहीं करते, बाहर निकलते हैं, गाड़ी में बैठते हैं, अपने ऑफिस जाते हैं, ऑफिस से वापस गाड़ी में बैठ के घर आ जाते हैं, खाते हैं, और उसके बाद डाइजेस्ट नहीं हो पाता सही तरीके से, तो फेट भी पड़ रही है, और जो फिजिकल होना चाहिए एक्सरसाइज वो नहीं हो पा रही है। तो एक बहुत अच्छा आइडिया आपका है, और बहुत अच्छा आपका, हिंदुस्तान में भी ये चीज लागू होनी चाहिए, मैं भी ऐसे चाहता हूँ, और मैं देखता हूँ लोगों को कितने उनकी मस्कुलर बॉडीज कितनी स्ट्रांग है, इम्यूनिटी हालांकि हिंदुस्तान में बहुत अच्छी है, आप जैसा देखते हैं हम लोग कितने मसाले और इतनी स्पेसीज वगैरह ये लोग हम लोग खाते हैं, यूज करते हैं, उससे कोविड में काफी हद तक हम लोग लड़ने में ज्यादा सक्षम है। तो ये आइडियाज हैं आपके, बहुत अच्छे हैं, मैंने साहब ने भी बहुत अच्छे आइडियाज दिए हैं जो बता रहे हैं, जो डिजाइनिंग के बारे में, तो काफी चेंजेस कर सकते हैं, और डिजाइन को तो चेंज होना चाहिए, क्योंकि हर बार एक इंसानी फितरत है, एक उसकी मेंटेलिटी है, हर चीज में बदलाव चाहता है। तो अगर हमारे पास बेस्ट डिजाइनर्स हैं, वो अगर हमें अलग अलग डिजाइन देते हैं, अलग अलग आइडियाज देते हैं, तो उसमें हमारे, हम लोगों के लिए, हमारे जो कला जगत के लोग हैं उन पे भी वो काफी उसमें चेंजेस आ सकता है, और उनकी कला को और निखारा जा सकता है, और नए ढंग से पेश किया जा सकता है।
बहुत सही फरमाया सर आपने। Mr. Menon, now coming to you, you know, while we are now wrapping up, so you know it also very well that, you know, balance is what really keeps society moving on. You know, a bit of this, a bit of that, you need everything to come together. So for you as someone, you know, who's basically, you know, in charge of the industry body for the automobile manufacturers, automobile association in India, for you over the next 12 months, you mentioned about scrappage as one very, very important initiative. You mentioned about, you know, the industry and the automakers looking at other, you know, ways of engaging with communities. So over the next 12 months, what would be the key, say, issues that you would want to address or tackle or work on?
You know, I would respond to that by saying that there are two approaches going forward, which we have started adopting now. We will strengthen that process. One, of course, is continuing with our advocacy. When I say advocacy, it involves engaging the government. So scrappage policy is one such area of engagement. We've had several discussions. We'll keep the discussion on scrappage. But also advocacy with the industry. And we do workshops. We do specific sessions with industry. So we have already identified areas like end of life vehicle regulations. We'll work with them on material recycling. We'll work with them on cleaner mobility. So these are all areas where we'll work going forward through specific workshops, specific sessions with the industry. So advocacy will involve engaging with both government and our own membership. Second element of community, definitely we as I mentioned, we already have two projects running. One is in Punjab, in Patiala district, which was on purely working with farmers on new technologies to so that they don't have to burn stubble. We're looking at newer areas of work, which includes decomposes, what's called microbial digester. So we'll keep that engagement on. We'll probably increase the scale. So this is just what we call pilot project where a few of our members are supporting us. We'll increase the scale and we'll work closely to make sure that we affect more, we reach out and we engage with more people in those communities. And we'll look at more such programs. So these are two areas you will see us deepening our engagement going forward in the next 12 to 18 months.
Okay, so interesting. So we've had an hour of a very interesting discussion on the subject of sustainability and as the topic says, now is the time to act. So all three of you are actually already acting on it in your respective roles, in your respective domains, whether it comes to building a city and nurturing communities, whether it comes to actually, nurturing an industry and taking it forward, and creating advocacy and engaging with all other industries and policymakers, or whether it comes to, propagating and taking an art form forward while taking all other art forms along with you. These are all aspects of sustainability. I mean, as I mentioned sometime earlier that, the United Nations has given us 17 goals, and for our country, we might have more or we might have less. We will have to have the ones which are most relevant to us and work on all of them. But all those goals are interlinked. Okay, none can work in isolation from the others. And that's why, one of the leading industries of the country, the automobile industry, that's why town planning, cities, the way cities are built, and that's why art forms, okay, artists, art forms, artisans, creators, ideators, they all need to come together because that is what really matters about sustainability. So on that note, I would thank all three of you, Debashish sir, Menon sir, and Shakir sir, for your time, for your inputs, for your thoughts. We've captured all of this. This is being recorded. I would request the CARTIST team to put it down, at least as a short action paper, because there are so many ideas that all three of you have shared. And if we can then, if CARTIST also as a forum, can then act upon these. So, possibly first and foremost, bring all the three of you together so that you can engage with each other. Like Debashish sir has given some ideas to Mr. Menon of, what kind of, shared personal mobility can be. Mr. Menon's talked about recyclability. He's talked about scrappage. He's talked about engaging with artists. Shakir sir has talked about as to how the artists can go across and express themselves in various forms. So our endeavor should be, my request to the CARTIST team is to put this down as a, as a short paper, which then can actually be acted upon. And that is where, thoughts actually come into action. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for your times. And to me, this is an excellent way to begin the CARTIST Festival 2020.